Hello and welcome. My name is Toshiro and this is Chicago 1930. We're gonna start with the police story. I was hoping I could like raise the difficulty, but I couldn't. I have to remain on medium. Anyway, the police, like, it's a little bit harder because I don't think I can kill anyone I like. So, let's see. Yes, we are here. Investigate on Dandy Daughtry murder. Okay, so we are backing up right after we killed Dandy Daughtry. So, let's see. I think I'm Edward Nash.
D.A. Dandy Daughtry was found dead in his home last night. According to our sources, Don Falcon seems to be involved. Not difficult to figure out based on the gruesome details in the official report. Go to the crime scene with your men and find some evidence, Nash. This time he's gone too far. Read my lips. I want Don Falcon. You hear me?
Yes. I hear you. I am Eduardo Nash. No more Burrito? I miss Jack Burrito. Okay, anyway. And who are you? I don't know your name. At least I know my boss name before. What is your name, Mystery Man? So, popularity is still 100%, which is good. Read my lips. Okay, I'm reading your lips, man. Your lips are very thin. Anyway, Edward Nash. Okay, no team, no equipment. We're gonna start from zero. Begin. Yes. Instruction. I know all that. Inventory, yes. Has a symbol of... Okay. I know.
Finally!
Wow, finally. Finally what? I am Sergeant Williams. They told me you would arrive. Edward, odd that they have called you in, seeing how the FBI is already on the case. Alright, follow me. I'll show you the stiff. Okay, no need to...
This way. Follow me.
Okay, for you, I am special agent. No FBI. Show me the murder scene.
Here comes the backup.
Yes, I am the backup. This is Agent Smith and Agent Smith, double Smith. Okay, Edward Nash from the Prohibition Division. Okay then, I'll open the doors for you, Edward.
FBI! I'm Agent Smith, and this is Agent Curtis!
I thought his name is also Smith. Yes, two FBI agent. Hello. It's the district attorney wife, Laura Daughtry, who found the corpse. She terribly shaken up, poor thing. You should talk with her. She's in her room. I know all about her. She cheated on him with someone. I killed both her husband and her lover. A damn cruel killing. He got a knife in the back. Yes, he got a knife. But strangely, we cannot find the knife. And where are all the men hired to protect Daughtry? Oh, they are dead. Burrito killed them all. Fine, okay. Too much reading. Here. I've got the fingerprints, so you can search your body if you want. Really? Okay. Here's the body. Take the body. Yes, I'm gonna play with the body. Okay, I don't think they care. They are looking at an empty place. They don't care about the body. Nobody care about the body. And what is this number? Number what? Is there a phone around? No? So I have angry agents. And what's in here? I am detective. I'm gonna solve the case. The case is solved. So, come on, work out. So, I'm looking for clues. Ooh. Really? But it does look like out of place, right? What is in here? There's a key in the vase. Oh. Who would put a key in the vase? Last time it was in the fish tank. You want to talk to the suspect. Daughtry's wife is in this room. No chance she can escape. All the doors are locked. One second, I'll open it for you. Yes, let me speak with his wife. Where is the lady? Show me the lady. Oh, hello lady. How ghastly this is. My husband is brutally murdered and they accuse me. They say that I've hidden the knife. Help me, won't you please?
Oh, my word.
Okay, I will help. Show me what you got. Okay, got nothing. Okay,
help.
I can open this door. So I'm in here. Let's open this and get rid of the key. Okay, seeing the key. Yes, you're safe. Yes, this is the fish tank. Okay, no more key. And I have the safe combination. And I have a book. These documents definitely clear Mrs. Daughtry of all suspicion. She had no reason to kill her husband. Okay, Mrs. Daughtry is innocent. And that what this mystery book says. Why does it say this? I don't know. Where are all the dead people? Dead people I have killed. Okay, they are still looking in the crowd. I'm feeling bad for them. I'm gonna bring him back. There you go. Here's the dead body. Yes, you keep taking picture. Hey lady, I found your photo album with your husband. It shows that you loved him. And that means you didn't kill him. Oh, there's someone there. Okay. Police. Are you eyewitness? Sir, these are our duties. Serve the public interest, protect the innocent, enforce respect for the law. Really? I didn't know that. Thank you for telling me. I was in the kitchen. Oh, this is the maid. Wasn't she dead? Throw a grenade. Miss Susie, I mean the little maid, passed out from the shock. I need to find something to bring her around, but I can't leave her alone. Okay, I'm gonna bring her around. Come here. Go around. Yes. Okay. Nothing happened. Get her around. Okay. Need a key.
I can't do this.
Yes, you can. Proper is the door to the district attorney office. I should be able to open it. Really? Are you stupid? Huh? Eduardo? Already opened, man. I think I'm looking for a med kit. Oh yes, I can talk to her now. A medical kit? Yes, of course. Try looking in the bathroom. I think Susie has the key. Do you think they're arresting?
What a disaster!
Oh my god, relax, the drama queen. A key? No, but you could ask Robert. He searched the maid. He is out on the balcony. Oh my god, Robert, give me the key. The key to the bathroom, it must be the one I found on her when I searched her. Here. Yes. And here's the medkit. Yes. Here you go. Oh, thank you. The shock was atrocious. Madam is innocent. I must tell you, I saw the knife. I'm sure that one of your colleagues has stolen it. Oh my god. A corrupted cop. Who stole the knife? Luigi Torillo, police officer. I come to help out. Okay, thank you. Who stole the knife? The recruiting standards have sure gone downhill. That Torillo has no sense of teamwork, and what's his present anyway? I'm going to keep my eye on him. Eduardo, I need to speak with you. Meet me discreetly in the children's room. Yes, in the baby's room. Eduardo, we have a real problem. I was watching Torillo and I think I saw him take an object and hide it on his person, and it looked to me like a knife. Catch my drift. With your permission, I'd like to talk with him. Okay. Did we have to go all this way? Just tell me this.
Hey, you!
Yes, you.
Freeze! Gotcha.
Torillo has a knife on him. Arrest him.
Freeze.
Oh my
I'll
god.
Shoot. Hands up.
Oh my god. Edward Nash. Too bad. Dumb. Torillo must be working for Falcone or somebody powerful bribed him. In any case, he hid the knife to cast suspicion on Mrs. Daughtry. Really? Edward, you couldn't like save this man?
I could get a Pulitzer for this!
Okay. To be handcuffed, Characters must surrender or be unconscious. Okay. Can they be dead? Yes. Here's the murder weapon. Okay, so I have too many keys.
Help!
I found the murder weapon. And where's the door? A locked door. There's a locked door in here. And I can open. Oh my god, I remember those police officers. Here's what happened to Dautry's personal protection force. They are all dead. I can think of only one man capable of hiding the body after the murder. A man who goes unseen, unsuspected. A seemingly your man, the Majordomo. No, here's the burrito. Who's the Majordomo? Arrest the Majordomo. This upgrade increases your shooting capability. Yes, I need this upgrade. Hello, Majordomo. To be handcuffed, character must be surrendered. Okay, success. Surrender.
Oh no!
Handcuff.
You have the right to remain silent.
Yes, here's the.
It appears as though Dan D. Doherty was killed for embezzling Don Falcon's money while masquerading as the Baron. The police and Chicago itself are corrupt to the bone. The President of the United States himself relies on your team to put Don Falcon behind bars and clean up the city. Don't forget it.
Okay, I won't forget it. So, Edward Nash, you need more shooting, Edward. You are bad. You could have saved that man, but he is dead now. Oh, yes. Yes. So, I didn't keep my skill points, but anyway. Edward, you need shooting. Barney Gleason. Gleason or Gleason? I don't know. Anyway, his name is Barney. A genius wheelman. No one gets away from him. His driving reflexes are lightning fast. Who cares? Donovan McNabb. The giant leprechaun is an indefatigable Irishman, whatever that means. A rowdy fighter. He practices judo, boxing, and hand-to-hand combat. Close combat man. Bowel Jankowski. Also dull in the looks department, Jankowski is a crack communications specialist. He's an experienced technician, always cool under pressure and fiercely brave. Man, what a bunch of ponies. I miss my old team. So he know how to drive, he can throw a punch, and he's like all this talk, big talk, but big talk. And this idiot can't even shoot. Okay, so that was the first police mission. Anyway, thank you everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please leave a like if you did. Subscribe to my channel for more videos, and I'll see you in the next time. Thank you and goodbye.